Welcome back, everyone. Today I'm working on the Citta, and I wanted to show you this new kill switch I got. This is from Stage6, and a couple different companies make these. Voca, I think, makes one. I picked up this kill switch. I haven't seen these in America before. These are mostly European on trials bikes. They are really cool. They're kind of like a jet ski kill switch, but instead of having a clip, it's 100% magnetic, which is really cool. You put this on and it opens the circuit so it doesn't ground the bike out. It runs. When you pull this, it closes the circuit, it grounds out the coil, kills the bike. I think this thing is super cool. If you want, you can attach it to your wrist and then have it on your throttle hand or do whatever you want. I had this on a different bike and I really loved it, and so I wanted to get one for the Citta. It's also cool because you can have one key. You get a couple of these, put them on all different mopeds or whatever you want, really. You could put it in your car if you wanted to. And you just have this little key, you pop it on there. It's really cool. It's also magnetic, so you can stick it to whatever you want. You can stick it to your fork nut for safekeeping, or do whatever you want. Like and subscribe, buy me a coffee if you can. And for a limited time, I will have some CornPed popcorn for the holiday season. Check out cornped.com. This switch is really cool. This thing just pops on and off. The lanyard does have a little quick disconnect if you want to take that off. It also has a little ball on here for adjustable. If you want to put it on your wrist, you can adjust it just like that, make it tighter, make it looser, do whatever you want. The ends have a female bullet terminal and a ring terminal. So this is your ground. You would attach this to the frame, you attach this to the coil, and then when you disconnect this, it grounds it out. This has a pretty simple mount. A lot of moped controls and scooter control mounts are like this. You just loosen that screw, these things pop out. And then they pop right back in, just like that. You can kind of adjust where you want this and then tighten it down. There you go. That's on, that's off. And put this little strap right here. If I don't wanna do it like that. I'm gonna route this down. I need to find a ground for this, and I'll connect this to the coil. I do have another video on wiring the CDI for this where I made a long wire for the coil, so I will show you that. This wire is coming from my coil. That is my kill switch. I can route that right up here, and that'll just go to this guy. Just like that. So I need a bullet connector. I have a whole kit. I'll post a link where I get these on Amazon. They're really handy to have on hand. You can use a special little crimper to make these really clean. There we go. I can slide this little waterproof protector up. There we go. Now we have a perfect little connection. That'll tuck right here behind the little wire cable. This one I am going to extend back. And I can just use the extra cable I have from the kill. Add some solder to my soldering iron. Put a little piece of shrink tubing on here. Just to clean it up. I think that'll work just like that. I'm gonna take the fender off. That'll just make putting this cover back on a lot easier. Okay. I picked up these little fender washers on Amazon. They make them in all different colors. I picked blue because I had a blue Pelini sticker on here. So why not match them? I'll put a link where you can get these. I think they're $9 for 20 of them. Here's that ground wire. I know it looks like I've got a lot of wires going on here, but I really don't. I'm just in the middle of finishing the wiring, so it's not completely cleaned up yet. I need a nice ground spot. I'm just gonna put it right there. So I'm gonna cut this. And there we go. Gonna put a little ring terminal on it. Okay. And then I'll shrink it. All right, put these back on. We got 1, 2, and 3. All right, there we go. We got a kill switch. Remember, these are my lighting wires. I will hook these up later in a lighting video, but right now I'm just working on the kill switch. We got a kill switch. You can leave it right, you can leave it connected. You can do whatever you want. So that's off, that's on. This thing's magnetic, you can stick to other things. I think this thing's really cool, and I'm probably gonna get some for my other bikes, and I'll have a universal key for all of them. It's a unique kill switch, and it works really well. I think it's really cool. Let me know what you guys think of this thing. Is there a reason you'd want one, a reason you wouldn't want one? Let me know in the comments. Have a great day.